In the previous lecture, we discussed about the line integral of electric field from an initial to a final point capital B. So there we saw that the line integral of electric field from initial to a final point, it just depends upon the position vector of initial point and that of the final point. So it does not depend upon the path which we are choosing. So no matter what kind of path you choose, as long as the initial and the final points they are the same, the line integral of electric field it will remain the same. So here I have taken a charge q. So this is the source charge, and in the surroundings of this source charge q there will be electric field due to this source charge. So I am taking a point A in space and another point capital B at another position in space. So first of all, we are going to evaluate line integral of electric field taken over the path ACB. So this path which is drawn with the pink color, so this is the ACB path, and we are doing the line integral of electric field over this path ACB. So what will be the line integral? So that we have done in the previous lecture, that moving from initial point to a final point, the line integral of electric field will be equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 by r a minus 1 by r b. So this line integral of electric field over the path ACB will be equal to q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 divided by r a. So r a vector is the position vector of the initial point. So this vector from the source charge to the A point, this will be the RA vector minus 1 by RB. So this charge, source charge Q, it is supposed to be present at the origin. So this vector will be equal to RA vector, and this vector will be the position vector of the final point B. And this is the relation, this is the equation of line integral of electric field taken over the path ACB. Now similarly, we are going to write the line integral of electric field over the path which is shown by yellow color. So we have taken two different paths. First we are moving through this path ACB, and then we are moving in the path AC prime B path, which is the path which is shown by yellow color. So now we are again finding the line integral of electric field over this path AC prime B, that is this lower path. So this line integral will also be having the same formula, because as we have seen in the previous lecture that the line integral of electric field, it does not depend upon the type of path that you are choosing. So it just depends upon initial and the final point. And for both these paths, initial and the final points, they are the same. So line integral of electric field from A to B point through this path AC prime B will be equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 by RA minus 1 by RB. So line integral on this path ACB, it will be same as the line integral of electric field over the path AC prime B. Now let's say we are going to find the line integral of electric field over a closed loop. So now we are going to find the line integral of electric field over a closed loop. Now in our case, what is the closed loop? Let's say if you are moving from A to C point, then to B point, and then you are moving back to the A point through this path B C prime A. So first you are moving from A, then moving to C point, then moving to B point, and then you are moving from B to C prime point, and then back to the A point. That is, you are moving in a closed loop. So now you are going to do the line integral of electric field over this closed loop. So what will be the line integral? First, it will be the line integral of electric field. So line integral of electric field over a closed loop, it can be divided into two parts in this case. So that will be equal to the open line integral from A to B point through this path ACB. So first of all, line integral of electric field over the closed path, it will be divided into two open line integrals. So first will be from ACB path. It will be for ACB path, electric field, line integral of electric field. Plus, we are going to do the line integral of electric field over the path BC prime A. So what we have done, we have divided the line integral of electric field over a closed path. Which was the path? It was ACB, then to C prime, then back to A. So now we have divided the line integral over this closed path into two paths, into two separate paths. So that are ACB, then BC prime A. So we have divided this line integral into ACB and BC prime A. So BC prime A. So we are moving in this direction. And this is the line integral of electric field. Now this will remain the same. ACB line integral, it will remain the same. So line integral of electric field for the path ACB, let's say it remains the same. Now this line integral of electric field, it is over the path BC prime A. It is from B then to C prime then to A. Now this line integral in this direction, it can be written as negative of the line integral in the opposite direction. Now the line integral over the path BC prime A, it can be written as negative of the line integral over the path AC prime B. So this line integral of electric field over the path BC prime A, it can be written as negative of the line integral of electric field over the path AC prime B. Now what is line integral of electric field over ACB path that we have already seen? It is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by RA minus 1 by RB. Then we have negative of the line integral of over the path AC prime B. Now what is this line integral? It is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by RA minus 1 by RB with negative sign. So this negative sign, it will remain as it is. So you can see that this term, it will cancel with this term, and this term will cancel with this term. So this whole left hand side, that is the line integral of electric field over a closed loop, it will come out to be equal to zero. So this is a very important result, that line integral of electric field over a closed loop is always equal to zero. So line integral of electric field over a closed loop, or you can say over a closed path, is always equal to zero. Now this is an important result. Now we will deduce another result from this particular result. So we will derive another result. Now first of all, we will use the Stokes theorem. The Stokes theorem, it says that line integral of any vector field over a closed loop, it can be written as the surface integral of the curl of that vector field. So you can go through what is Stokes theorem in the first chapter. So there we had seen that line integral of a vector field over a closed loop, it is equal to the surface integral. So here we have two integrals, means it is the surface integral. So this line integral over a closed loop is always equal to the surface integral, that is dot ds vector. So surface integral of curl of vector field. And what is this surface integral? This surface integral is done over the surface which is enclosed by this closed loop. So this closed loop, it will enclose some surface, and this surface integral is done over this surface which is enclosed by this loop over which we are doing integration on the left hand side. So this is the Stokes theorem that we have already done in the first chapter. Now this Stokes theorem is valid for every vector field, but here we are considering the electric field vector. So this equation, it will be valid, it will also be valid for the electric field. So in place of A vector, we can write E vector. So we have written the Stokes theorem for the case of electric field in this particular form. So on the left hand side, what we have, line integral of electric field over a closed loop. And just now we have derived that We have derived the result that line integral of electric field over a closed loop is always equal to zero. So the left hand side of Stokes theorem for the case of electric field will always be equal to zero, which means this surface integral of curl of vector E, this will always be equal to zero. So from this equation, we will see, we can say that the curl of vector E, curl of electric field, is always equal to zero. So in the Stokes theorem, this left hand side will be equal to zero because line integral of electric field over a closed loop is always equal to zero. So therefore, we can say that curl of vector E, that is curl of electric field, it is always equal to zero. So this is another important result for the case of electric field. So what we have derived, that line integral of electric field over a closed loop is always equal to zero, as well as the curl of vector E, curl of the electric field, is always equal to zero. Now we are going to see what is the work done to move a charge Q0 from A to B point in the space. So this term we have already seen in the starting of this chapter, that what is the work done to move a test charge Q0 from A to B point in the presence of a source charge. So let's say we have a source charge Q and you are moving a test charge Q0 from one point to another in the presence of the electric field of the source charge Q. So what is the work done to move a test charge Q0 from A to B point in the presence of electric field? So that came out to be equal to minus Q0 with the line integral of electric field from initial to the final point. So this was the equation that we had derived for the case of work done to move a charge Q0. To move a test charge Q0 from A to B point in the presence of electric field. So the work done is given by minus Q0 with line integral of electric field from A to B point. Now, what is the work done to move a unit test charge? Let's say if Q0 is equal to, it's put equal to 1. So for the case of a unit test charge, we will put Q0 is equal to 1. So in that case, that is work done to move from the work done to move a unit test charge, a unit test positive charge, that is Q0 is equal to 1. The work done to move a unit test charge from A to B point in the presence of electric field, it will be just equal to minus of line integral of electric field from A to B point. So this is the work done to move a unit test charge from A to B point in the presence of electric field. So just we will put Q0 is equal to 1 and we will get this equation. And in the previous lecture, we have seen that the line integral of electric field for the case of a point charge, point source charge, the line integral of electric field from A to B point is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 by Ra minus 1 by Rb. So this we have already seen. So what will be the work done to move a unit test positive charge from A to B point? So that is equal to minus of line integral of electric field from A to B point. So that will be equal to, so we will put this equation over here. So we will put this equation in this last step. So we will get Q by 4 pi epsilon naught. And here we have 1 by Ra minus 1 by Rb. But we have to consider this negative sign also. So the work done to move a unit test positive charge from A to B point, so that will be equal to negative of this integral, that is negative of this whole term. So that will be equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by Rb minus 1 by Ra. So this is the work done to move a unit test positive charge from A to B point, from A to B point for the case of a point source charge. So we have seen work done, and now we are going to see what is the potential difference between two points in the electric field. So the work done to move a test charge from A to B point, the work done to move a test charge Q0. So if you have a source charge plus Q and you have a test charge Q0 and you are moving this test charge from A to B point, so you have to do some work against the electric field. And what is the work done to move a test charge Q0 from A to B point? That we have seen that it is equal to minus Q0 with the line integral of electric field from A to B point. Now we are going to see what is the potential difference. So what is this term? Now potential difference between two points in an electric field. Potential difference between two points in the electric field, that is equal given by delta V. So delta V is the potential difference between A and B point, and that is equal to VB minus VA. So this is the potential at B point minus the potential at A point. So the potential difference between A and B point is given by VB minus VA, and that is equal to the work done to move a test charge from A to B point divided by the magnitude of the test charge. So this you have to remember, that the potential difference between two points in the electric field is given by the work done to move a unit positive test charge from A to B point. So potential difference between A and B point is given by the work done to move a unit test charge from A to B point. So this is the formula for the potential difference between two points in the electric field. So that is the total work done. It is the work done to move Q0 from A to B point. Then you divide by the magnitude of the charge, magnitude of the test charge, which is Q0. So this becomes the work done to move a unit test charge from A to B point. Now what is the SI unit of potential difference? That is nothing but volt, and it is represented by capital V. And what is 1 volt of potential difference? How do we define 1 volt of potential difference? So we just have to put over here 1 joules. So 1 joules, and you have to put over here 1 unit of, or you can say 1 coulomb test charge. So to define 1 volt of potential difference between two points, so the potential difference between two points in electric field is 1 volt when 1 joule of work is done. When 1 joule of work is done to move a test charge of 1 coulomb from initial to the final point. So potential difference between A and B is said to be 1 volt when 1 joule of work is to be done to move a 1 coulomb test charge from A to B point. So in that case, the potential difference between A and B, it will said to be 1 volt. Now the potential difference delta V is given by VB minus VA, and that is equal to WAB, which is the work done to move Q0 from A to B point, divided by the magnitude of the test charge, which is Q0. Now this WAB, what is this work done? It is nothing but minus Q0 with the line integral of electric field. So we will put the expression of the work done to move a charge from A to B point. So that will be, so delta V will be equal to 1 by Q0, it will remain as it is, and instead of WAB we will put the equation, this particular first equation. So instead of WAB we will put this formula, so that is minus Q0 with the line integral of electric field from A to B point. So Q0 and Q0, they will cancel with each other, and the potential difference, it will come out to be negative of the line integral of electric field from A to B point. So this is the formula of the potential difference between two points in the electric field of a source charge Q. Now we are going to see another definition, which is the electric potential. Electric potential is defined in the similar way to that of potential difference. Now in the case of electric potential, what is the difference? In the case of potential difference, we moved the test charge Q0 from A to B point in space. But in the case of electric potential, we will move the test charge from we will move a unit test charge from infinity to a particular point in space. So let's say if you have a source charge plus q, and you will move the unit test charge from infinity to a particular point in space. So that is how we define the electric potential. Here we moved the test charge Q0 from A to B point. That is, the initial point was capital A and final point was capital B. But in the case of electric potential, we will move the test charge from infinity. Now in this case, the initial point in the case of electric potential, the initial point will be infinity. So capital A point, it will be infinity. In the case of potential difference, we moved from A to B point, but in the case of electric potential, we are moving from infinity to a particular point. So in the case of electric potential, A is put to be equal to infinity. So what is electric potential? It is the work done to move a unit test positive charge. So in the case of potential difference, so what was the potential difference? It was the work done to move a unit test positive charge from a particular point A to another point B in space. Now electric potential is defined as the amount of work done to move a unit test positive charge. So here also we define potential difference as the work done to move a unit test positive charge, and here also we define electric potential as work done to move a unit test positive charge. But the difference comes with the limits. That is, here we moved from A to B point in space, but now here we are moving the test charge from infinity to a particular point in the electric field. So in this case, we are moving the test charge, unit test positive charge, from infinity to a particular point, any point. Let's say this point is P. So we are moving from infinity to P in the electric field vector E. So this work done to move a unit test positive charge from infinity to a particular point in space, that is called as the electric potential, whereas potential difference is defined as the work done to move a unit test positive charge from A to B point. So electric potential, it is denoted by capital V, and the units will be the same. The potential difference is defined by, it is measured in volts, and electric potential is also measured in volts. Now the electric potential capital V, it will have the formula. So the formula, it will be similar to that of the potential difference. Now potential difference between A and B points, the potential difference between A and B point is, it was defined by the line integral of electric field from A to B point. So we are moving from A to B point. So we have to do the line integral of electric field from A to B point with the negative sign. So that will give us the potential difference between these two points. So electric potential, in the case of electric potential, instead of A, so we are moving from A to B in the case of potential difference, but in the case of electric potential, we are moving from infinity to a point P. So this potential will be defined by negative, so negative sign, it will remain the same, with the line integral of electric field from infinity to a P point. So this is how we define the electric potential at a particular point P. So electric potential at a particular point P is defined as the work done to move a unit test positive charge from infinity to move a unit test positive charge from infinity to that point in space. So the amount of work that has to be done, that is called as the electric potential at P point. Let's revise the formulas that we have just done. So we had seen that line integral of electric field, that is line integral of electric field along a path from A to B point, it was given by, for the case of a source charge, point source charge, that was given by Q by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by RA minus 1 by r b. So this is how, this is the relation of the line integral of electric field with that of the position vectors of the initial and the final points. Then we saw the line integral of electric field over a closed path, it always came out to be equal to zero. And using this relation, we found the curl of electric field is also always equal to zero. Then we saw the work done to move a unit test positive, the work done to move a charge Q0 from A to B point. So that work done is given by minus Q0 with the line integral of electric field from A to B point. And then for a unit test positive charge, we will put Q0 is equal to 1. So in that case, the work done to move a unit test positive charge from A to B point, it will be just equal to negative of line integral of electric field from A to B point. So from here then we define the potential difference between A and B. So potential difference between A and B point is given by delta V, and that is equal to VB minus VA, and that comes out to be equal to negative of line integral of electric field from A to B point. So this is the potential difference between these two points. Then we define the electric potential at a point P in electric field. So electric potential is defined as the amount of work done to move a unit test positive charge from infinity to a point P in space. So in this case of electric potential, A will be equal to infinity and B is P point. So B we have taken as P in the case of electric potential. So the formula, it will remain the same, but limits will change. So A, it will become infinity, and since we are talking about a P point, so we will replace B with P. An electric potential at a point is said to be 1 volt. So how do we define the electric potential of 1 volt? So electric potential at a point is said to be 1 volt when 1 joule of work is to be done to move 1 coulomb test charge from infinity to that point which we are considering. So electric potential at a point is said to be 1 volt when 1 joule of work is to be done to move a unit, to move 1 coulomb of test charge from infinity to that point in space. So that is how we define 1 volt of electric potential at a point in space. Using this formula of electric potential, we will derive the electric potential at a point due to a point charge. So we will derive the exact formula of finding the electric potential at a point due to a point charge. So let's consider we have a source charge plus Q, and this is placed at the origin of the coordinate axis. So we have the three coordinate axes x, y and z, and the source charge Q is placed at the origin of the coordinate system. Now the test charge has to be moved because we want to find the electric potential, and for the case of electric potential, we move the test charge from infinity to a particular point P in space. So we are moving the test charge from infinity. So we are moving the test charge from infinity to a particular point P in the space. So the amount of work done to move this unit test positive charge from infinity to a P point, that will give us the expression of the electric potential at P point. So let's say the position vector of P point. The position vector of P point is given by r vector. So this is the position vector of the P point, and we are moving the test charge from infinity to a particular point P in the space. So let's say we are taking this particular path which is shown by red color. So we are particularly moving in this particular curve. So we are moving in this particular curve, and let's consider the position of the test charge at any point in space. Let's say we are considering this point for a particular instant of time. So we are moving the test charge from infinity to P point, and let's consider we have moved the charge from infinity to this point. So let's consider a particular instant in the path. So this point, it is having a position vector of r vector, small r vector. So this is the position vector of this point. Now the electric field at any point, let's say if you're considering this point, so we have to move the test charge from infinity to P point following this path. But now for time being we are considering just this point. So the test charge, it is moved from infinity to P point, but we are considering a particular point along the path. Let's say we are considering this point, and this point is having a position vector of small r vector. Now what is the electric field at this particular point due to the source charge plus Q? So that will point in the radial outward direction. So this will be the direction of the electric field at this particular point. So electric field will be given by Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 by r square into r cap. So this is how we give the formula of electric field at a particular point due to a point charge. So that is given by Q by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by r square into r cap. So now electric field, it will point in radial outward direction. Now potential, electric potential is defined by the negative of the line integral of electric field from infinity to a point P which we are considering in the space. So first of all, to find the electric potential, the main task of this article is to find electric potential at a point, that is the P point. So to find electric potential, first of all we have to find E vector dot dl vector. So E vector dot dl vector, this will be equal to at this particular point. So we are considering this point for a time being. So at this particular point, electric field is pointing in the radial outward direction, and dl vector. So what is dl vector? Dl vector is pointing in this direction. So this is the direction of dl vector because we are moving from infinity to a point P. So at this particular point, the dl vector, it will point in this particular direction. So what will be E vector dot dl vector at this point? So that will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by r square into r cap dot product with dl vector. So E vector is nothing but Q by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by r square r cap, and we have to do E dot dl vector. So that will be nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by r square, this will remain as it is, into r cap dot product with dl vector. So now we are going to find what is r cap dot product with dl vector. Now r cap dot product with dl vector, let's say this is the, as we had said, this is the electric field, and let's say the angle between E vector and dl vector, that is given by theta. The angle between E vector and dl vector, let's say that is given by theta at this particular point. So r cap dot product with dl vector, r cap dot product with dl vector, that will be magnitude of r into magnitude of dl into cos of angle. So that will be just dl cos theta. So this r cap dot dl vector will be equal to dl cos of theta. Now this dl cos theta, dl cos theta is nothing but the projection of dl vector along E vector. Now if you say this is the E vector, this is the direction of E vector, and this was the dl vector. In our case, this was the dl vector. So dl cos theta is nothing but the projection of dl vector along E vector. So this will be the dl cos theta. So here we have dl cos theta, and we can see that in this particular triangle, dl cos theta is nothing but the projection of dl vector along E vector, and E vector is nothing but in the radially outward direction. E vector is in the radial outward direction. So this dl cos theta is the component of dl along the r vector. E vector, electric field vector, is along r vector, so it is in the radially outward direction, and dl cos theta will also be in the radially outward direction. dl cos theta this dr cos theta, it will also be in the radial outward direction. So this small length element, it will be nothing but equal to dr. So this dr cos theta is nothing but the small length along e vector. It is the small length along E vector, and E vector is nothing but along R vector. So this small length will be just equal to dr. So this is the small length element along the radial direction. So the potential at a particular point P, that will be given by, this potential will be given by the line integral of electric field from infinity to P point with the negative sign. So potential at P point will be equal to line integral of electric field. So line integral of electric field E vector dot dl vector, it has just come out to be equal to this expression. So we will put this E vector dot dl vector over here. So we will put this expression of E vector dot product with dl vector over here. So that will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square into dr. So E vector dot dl vector is equal to this expression, and we are going to find the potential, electric potential at P point. So electric potential at P point is nothing but equal to negative of the line integral of electric field. So we will put this insert. We will insert the formula of E vector dot dl vector, which we have just derived. So we will insert in this equation. So we will get 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square into dr with the integration from infinity to P point. So the test charge is moved from infinity to P point. But in this case, the variable is r. In this case, the variable is r because we have dr over here. So the limits will be from infinity to capital R. So this point which we had taken for a particular instant of time, so this point, it was at r distance from the source charge. But in actual, we are moving the test charge from infinity to this point, final point P. And this final point P, it is at a distance of capital R from the source charge. So the limits of R will be from infinity to capital R. So the limits of R will be from infinity to capital R. So you will solve this integration. So when you will solve this integration, you will get the potential at P point. It will be equal to, now minus q by 4 pi epsilon naught, it will come out of the integration, and inside the integral you will be just left with dr divided by r square. So you will be just left with these two terms. So dr divided by r square with the limits from infinity to capital R. So on solving this integration, so when you will solve this integration, you will get the potential at P point. The potential at this particular point due to the source charge q is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q divided by the capital R, which is the distance of the point from the source charge. So the potential at P point due to a source charge plus q, it comes out to be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q divided by the distance of the this particular point P from the source charge, and the distance is nothing but capital R. So this is the potential at P point due to a point source charge.